Hey guys, it's Asia O'Hara, and I'm so excited to be bringing you a brand new series where we count down some of the most memorable moments in Drag Race history. That's right, we are curating 10 of the most iconic times the queens have left you gagging. Don't adjust your screens because we are just getting started. Today's topic is fashion on the runway, and there is no better way to start than with our top 10 pick. From season 10, that bitch from New York City, my girl Aquaria.
Number 10.
Y'all, she was my biggest competition, y'all already know, but Aquaria did that. After a phenomenal season, including wins in both the Ball Challenge and Snatch Game, Aquaria turned it out as Sabatina and cemented her place as the queen to beat. This look was iconic. Of course, Rue raved about the silhouette and the fabric. I learned what ocelot is. I had never heard of that. We don't have those in Texas. It was great. We were all gagging. We're still gagging.
That animal print, that silhouette, I was gobsmacked.
Number 9.
Next on our list throws us back to season 4, episode 1, when Sharon Needles shook up Drag Race and brought the runway to Rupocalyptic proportions.
Ooh, look at those eyes. Nosferatu too. Oh, she's bleeding.
Oh, my goodness.
Somebody call a dentist.
Blood was spilt that day as Sharon introduced a new kind of aesthetic to RuPaul's Drag Race, embracing the spooky and influencing new generations of queens to come. Halloween has never been the same.
It's a disco bloodbath.
Oh, yeah.
I've had the pleasure of touring with the Queen of Halloween, and trust me, this runway look is an accurate representation of her day-to-day life.
Number 8.
Known for her skilled lip syncing and contagious personality, season 9's runner-up, Peppermint, stumbled into a few fashion roadblocks.
It just was a whole bunch of a mess.
But Miss Thing certainly shut down any skepticism when she turned the corner in the tastiest, candylicious club kid look yet. As a queen at home, this is the moment in the season where you're like, okay, Peppermint came to slay.
Oh, that was refreshing.
Number 7.
In season 6, Courtney Act had countless runway highlights, like her epic homage to Klaus Nomi in episode 7's Black and White Runway. But it was her Animal Kingdom look, 2 episodes later, that set her on a path to the top 3 and a shot at giving winner Bianca Del Rio a run for her money.
Baloney!
This was a time in Drag Race history where we first saw a queen with something truly larger than life on the runway, and really we thought anything is possible. Those wings were everything.
Number 6.
Who doesn't love All Stars 2? A stacked season of some of the most epic queens in Drag Race history, and they did not disappoint. I personally think the best season ever. And episode 6 brought us a super fun category.
Pants!
Pants on the runway.
Pants, I said.
Next on our countdown is one of my personal favorites, Katya.
Katya, the Russians are taking over the runway.
I'm giving you 1980s lesbian literary agent, disinterested, pissed off Ellen Barkin fantasy.
And she has never looked this good in vintage Mugler tracksuits.
Number 5.
Fans of season 3 of Drag Race know that Raja and Manila tour up every single week, battling it out for Queen Supreme and looks that still hold up today. While Raja was, of course, the ultimate champion of that season, our next pick goes to Manila and a look we all know and love her for.
Manila Luzon.
Oh!
Is that a bomb? Everybody down!
I'm just swaying my hips and smiling and showing off my purse and having a gay old time.
Fun fact, Manila wore an evolved version of this dress to the All Stars 4 premiere party.
Number 4.
Up next, all bow to season 9 winner Sasha Velour, who left an undeniable impact on a season full of tough competition. But when it was time to return in season 10 to pass on her crown, Sasha made sure her Alien Eve look would truly be her crowning jewel, one of the most remarkable looks in the world. You have to see this in person, as I did. The details are remarkable. It is wonderful craftsmanship. Sasha Velour is probably one of the most artistic people in the world. Now, because I'm the host of this damn show, I'm looking back at some of my own personal moments for these categories. So up first is fashion. My hat's incredible look. Shout out to my girls, Blair St. Clair and Aquaria, for helping me put it together for a week in the workroom. This was one of my things that I was most excited about bringing and showcasing. Of course, I didn't win. That's okay. But I still love it, and it's one of my favorite things ever. I love a dandelion.
Number 3.
It's a small world, and we are all just living in it. No fashion list is complete without honoring the leggy goddess herself, Naomi Smalls. Naomi cemented herself as one to watch in season 8 when she shined in her scarecrow couture. But it was her final runway look from All Stars 4 that makes our list of memorable fashion moments.
This is Naomi Smalls at her highest form. I am shining from head to toe. I am looking rich, bitch. I am looking opulent.
It is iconically her. Her favorite color is purple, which is also Naomi Campbell's favorite color. It is just literally her saying, this is me at my finest.
I own everything.
Naomi truly is that bitch.
Number 2.
It should not surprise anyone that very high on our list of Drag Race fashion herstory is the one and only Detox. Not only did she hit us with the slow verse in season 5, but her return in All Stars 2 was legendary when she stomped the runway week after week and look after look. There literally was not a bad runway. But if we have to honor just one of Detox's looks, her latex look will go down forever in history as the moment that Detox inserted herself as a contender for the crown and became an overall fashion icon. It is literally that good. And trust me, it is not easy walking down the runway under hot stage lights in latex. Latex pants at that.
Number 1.
It should come as no surprise that in the long list of Drag Race winners, one queen in particular has truly come close to the ideals of fashion perfection. And you all know exactly who I'm talking about. The Wasp woman herself, Violet Tchotchke. Violet burnt the runway in season 7 with memorable looks such as her Death Becomes Her eye-popping, waist-defying costume that even made Ariana Grande gag.
Oh my God.
But it was on season 8 when Violet returned to pass on her crown that earns its spot at the top of our list for jaw-dropping memorable fashion moments. Name one other moment like it. How dare you?
Violet Tchotchke!
Such a high glamour, high impactful moment, and the way she glided across the stage like a freaking wasp, it was great. She's a wasp. It's an important thing to take from this. Sound off in the comments below with your favorite fashion looks and stay tuned for future episodes where we will count on other canon Drag Race moments that shook the herstory books and still left us wanting more. I'm Asia O'Hara, signing out. Until next time, bye.
Do you want everything RuPaul's Drag Race at your fingertips? Then head over to YouTube now and subscribe to the RuPaul's Drag Race channel, and you will get all the episodes of everything you ever want, including brand new episodes of Whatcha Packin'. Hi.